evening. It's good to have you all here tonight. We're going to have a great time. And we've got a good program coming up here, and we just appreciate everyone who comes to participate. And it's a good time of the year, isn't it? I hope you've all had a good Christmas and been blessed in a wonderful way. And it's just so good to be able to come together tonight to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And let's begin tonight with a word of prayer, shall we? Let's pray. Father, we thank you tonight that we can come together to praise your name. We thank you, Lord, that we can celebrate your birth. And because of your birth, we have the blessed assurance that as you came that first time, you're going to come again. And because of you, Lord Jesus, we have a hope in a troubled world. And we know you're coming again to take us to yourself, and we have given our hearts to you. So bless our service tonight, for we pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's turn our hymn book tonight to number 171. 171. Okay, number 171, Joy to the World. I hope you got joy in your heart tonight. Amen. All right.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And
her, and she's going to be sharing with us tonight, Jenny.
Good
In our hymn book to another psalm, 178. Sure became an important one.
Still we see thee lie above. born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Amen. At this time, we're going to call on the Catherine Chuck children, since we got Amber up here already. We love to have these kids come, and it's fun to watch them grow up, isn't it? And just see how God is working in their lives. Would you come?
Put a microphone on them.
Lay down your burden. Lay down.
Thank you very much. Well, once again, we are going to have a skit. This is a skit that is called the Tale of Three Trees. So if you ready to come up? Everybody around there? Okay. So anyway, Tale of Three Trees.
Shining axe, the third tree fell. The first tree rejoiced when the woodcutter brought her to his shop, but the busy carpenter was not thinking about treasure chests. Instead, his work-worn hands fashioned the tree into a feed box for animals. The once beautiful tree was not covered with gold or filled with treasure. She was coated with sawdust and filled with hay for hungry farm animals. The second tree smiled when the woodcutter took him to a shipyard, but no mighty sailing ships were being made that day. Instead, the once strong tree was hammered and sawed into a single fishing boat, too small and too weak to sail an ocean or even a river. He was taken to a little lake. Every day he brought the loads of dead, smelly fish. The third tree was confused when the woodcutter cut him into strong beams and left him in a lumberyard.
What happened? All I ever wanted to do was stay on the mountaintop and point to God.
Many, many days and nights passed. The three trees nearly forgot their dreams. But one night, golden starlight poured over the first tree as a young woman placed her newborn baby in a feed box.
I wish I could make a cradle for him,
her husband whispered. The mother squeezed his hand and smiled as the starlight shone on the smooth and sturdy wood.
This nature is beautiful.
And suddenly, the first tree knew.
I am one of the greatest treasures in the world.
One evening, a tired traveler and his friends crowded into the old fishing boat. The traveler fell asleep as the second tree quietly sailed into the lake. Soon a thrashing storm arose. The little tree shuddered. He knew he did not have the strength to carry so many passengers safely through the wind and rain. The tired man awakened, stood up, stretched out his hands and said, "Peace." The storm stopped as quickly as it began, and suddenly the second tree knew.
I am carrying the King of Heaven and Earth.
One Friday morning, the third tree was startled when his beams were yanked from the forgotten woodpile. He flinched as he was carried through an angry, jeering crowd. He shuddered when angels nailed a man's hands to him. He felt ugly and harsh and cruel. But on Sunday morning, when the sun rose and the earth trembled beneath him, the third tree knew.
God's love has changed everything.
It had made the first tree beautiful, it had made the second tree strong, and every time people thought of a third tree, they would think of God. That was better than being the tallest tree in the whole world.
Thank you very much. Job well done, isn't it?
Yes, amen.
Job well done, yes. How many times do we feel like those trees? What can God do with us? Like God can do anything, can do. Amen. Amen. Well, at this time, I'm going to call on Robbie to come up and he's going to sing a song without any music.
Be lucky you let him talk.
Well, I was asked to do a song for tonight, and my voice still isn't quite up to par. So, no song. But by a special request, I had somebody ask something. And I thought, you know what? I think I'll read this. I haven't heard this song in years, and yes, it's the one you asked about. So, it's called The Christmas Shoes. And at one time, this was a country gospel song, Christmas song, that was put out many years ago. When I was a kid, I remember hearing it. So, it's been out a long time, but I haven't heard it in many years. It's called The Christmas Shoes. It was almost Christmas time, and there I stood in another line, trying to buy that last gift or two, not really in the Christmas mood. Standing right in front of me was a little boy waiting anxiously, pacing round like little boys do, and in his hands he held a pair of shoes. And his clothes were worn and old, and he was dirty from head to toe, and when it came to his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. "Sir, I want to buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve, and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes will make her smile. And I want her to look beautiful if mama meets Jesus tonight." He counted pennies for what seemed like years. Then the cashier said, "Son, there's not enough here." He searched his pockets frantically. And then he turned and he looked at me. He said, "Mama made Christmas good at our house, though most years she just did without. Tell me, sir, what am I going to do? Somehow I've got to buy her these Christmas shoes." So I laid the money down, and I just had to help him out. And I'll never forget the look on his face when he said, "Mama's gonna look so great. Sir, I want to buy these shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes would make her smile. And I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight." I knew I'd caught a glimpse of heaven's love as he thanked me and went out. I knew that God had sent that little boy to remind me what Christmas is all about. "Sir, I want to buy those shoes for my mama, please. It's Christmas Eve, and these shoes are just her size. Could you hurry, sir? Daddy says there's not much time. You see, she's been sick for quite a while, and I know these shoes would make her smile. And I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight. I want her to look beautiful if Mama meets Jesus tonight." When you think about the words of that, you know, it makes you remember. Christmas is a time of giving. Giving sometimes to the point of hurt. You see, it isn't about receiving, other than the gift of Jesus when he was born and he came to pay the penalties for our sins. So, I just want to remind everybody that at Christmas time, remember, it's not Santa Claus and it's not presents. You know, it's not what you get. It's what you give to others who need. It's what you do from your heart out of love for others and the sacrifices we make for others. And that is what the joy of Christmas brings. And that's how it is best to remember Jesus, is to be his hands and feet and to share love with others at this time of year.
Amen. Thank you. We're going to, I think at this time we're going to receive our evening offering. And so if we could get, since Robbie, you're already standing, get him halfway down. It's hard to reverse, isn't it?
I'm
down. Yeah, all right. Then I'm going to walk all the way back there. And, but anyway, we do want to receive an offering tonight, and we appreciate everybody that's come. By the way, we're not done yet. So, but we're going to receive our offering at this point, and so we get another usher to come. Great. Well, let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you tonight for the greatest gift of all, and that is the gift of our Lord Jesus. And that had a perfect purpose in it. Even as we saw tonight in the tale of three trees, each one had a reason for being alive, for growing, and going through all they did. And so, Lord, we thank you that even though as people looked at the little babe in a manger, they could not understand what lay ahead. And the price that was given that day. And so, Lord, as we give our gifts, our offerings to you tonight, let us give with joy as we give unto the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. While the offering is being received tonight, I do want to mention that the program you're seeing tonight will be aired on Garden Valley Cable Thursday morning at 10 o'clock. And then we'll also be putting this onto our website, which is onto YouTube. And so you can pick it up on your computer. And I don't know how long it's going to take, Jeremy, to get that up there too. And but anyway, we have some cards in the back. You can pick them up to get on our website. It's just gosen-church.com. And then go to the concert series, and it'll be on that. So you can see this whole thing. And I hope that's all right with you that are... Do you mind being on TV? Do you mind? Seeing worldwide. But anyway, that's what's going to happen. And then when we're done tonight, we'll be going downstairs for refreshments. And a good time, so invite you to stay for that. But anyway, we're going to do a song or two now, and trust you'll be blessed.
Pray God.
There was another verse to that, yeah. Sometimes you hit that button, it just kind of jumps ahead of you. Oh, we're going to do a different, another one here that you're familiar with. And by the way, that last song, that was written by an old preacher a few years back. And professionals do it for them first. Between professionals and amateurs, professionals make better mistakes. That song that we that first one we did is one that I wrote written several a few years back, and we just found it. And I thought, we gotta try that. We should have tried it a little bit more. But anyway. You know, things don't always go right in life, does it? There's a lot of things that go on that we have a hard time with. We make mistakes. You can either go hide your head, you know, and get depressed, Or you can just look at your mistakes and say, hey, I'm going to do better next time. And you can forgive yourself, and you can press on. And you know, we've watched some of the professional musicians, and they've lost their places in music. And you know, I'm thinking about you kids, you know, when you're singing, don't ever be afraid to make a mistake. You learn from them, and you press on. The only people that don't make mistakes are the people that never try, never do anything. But you start over again, and you learn. But that's the way life is too. And you see, that's the reason Jesus came. Because we're full of mistakes. No matter how hard we try, we blow it. But God is a God of mercy and a God of forgiveness. And the message of the manger, the message of the birth of Christ, was that Jesus was born because we are imperfect. We struggle with life. We fail. And the only way we can keep going is by being forgiven. And that's what God wants us to do, doesn't he? He wants us to press on. And he wants us to call upon him in our failures. You see, Jesus was born that he may live a perfect life. And that perfect life, he's the only one that could do that. Because we can. He was born that he could live a perfect life, and he was born that he could die to take the place, our place, because we blew it. So we can be forgiven. And if we look at our lives, we find there's a lot of those times in which we blew it. But Jesus is the one who steps in. And we say, Lord, I'm sorry. Will you forgive me? And he takes the worst mistakes you could ever make. And he forgives them. And he takes you by the hand and he says, come on, let's start over again. Let's start all over again. And he leads us through. The message of Bethlehem was that we needed someone to carry us through this life. We needed someone because we are imperfect. But Jesus Christ is the one who forgives us, who cleanses us, and who makes it possible to start all over again. Just the other day, I turned on Facebook. I don't know how many of you are on Facebook, but I turned on Facebook, and I don't get a lot of time to do that. And guess who I saw on Facebook? Me. I was doing the funeral service. And this whole funeral service was on Facebook. I didn't know that was going to be on there. This is from a year ago. But the interesting thing, the reason I'm telling you that, is because the man who died had been a friend of mine for many, many years. But he was a man who made many mistakes. Gave his life to Christ many years ago. But he kept falling to alcohol. He tried, he tried, he tried, and he stumbled and he fell. He failed and failed and failed until his family was ready to throw him out. But he kept trying. I talked to him and he kept coming to me and he said, Gary, he said, I blew it again. The guy's name is Gordy. I said, Gordy, start all over again. Just start over again. And 2 years before he died, God picked him up and he didn't fall again. He had victory. And I was privileged to stand in front of that bunch of people and say, I know he's with Jesus today. because he did give up. You see, Jesus has not given up on you. And you may have failed in life. You may be struggling. But God didn't give up. And whenever you think of that new little baby in a manger, just think of that new life. New life given that we can have new life. Aren't you glad God didn't give up on you? Aren't you glad? But he kept on and he kept on and kept on so that you could find victory. And that one day you'll be able to stand in the courts of glory because Jesus won the battle for you. And tonight, as you think about this Christmas program, and you think about the things you've seen, the things you've heard, remember this. Jesus is the reason for the whole season. And he wants to bring victory into your life. Satan wants you to give up. Satan tells you there's no hope. But every time you think of that baby in the manger, remember, it was new life. God wants a new life in you. And remind yourself every time you look in the mirror, I'm a new creation, I'm a brand new man. Unless you're a woman. But Jesus wants to make you new and give you life. Amen. We're going to do one more song here, and then we're going to have our birthday cake for Jesus. Let's turn our hymn book one more time, and if Amber, can we get you to come again one more time? And we're going to turn to Silent Night, and that's 195. I didn't warn you about this, but you're good. 195.
Amen.
We want to bring the birthday cake up. You know, this is Jesus' birthday. And we want to sing happy birthday to Jesus. And the way that Jesus can, you know, the way that we can make Jesus the happiest on his birthday is that you allow him to be born in your heart. He's still looking for a place to be born, you know. And if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, let him be born in your heart today. But let's sing together, happy birthday to Jesus. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Jesus. Thank you that tonight we could have this Christmas program. And Lord, we thank you that we've been able to celebrate again your birth. And we pray, Lord Jesus, that tonight each one here will truly know that you have been born in their heart and that you live within them and that you forgive all sin when they call upon you. So, Lord Jesus, we give you praise tonight for the opportunity to wish you a happy birthday. Amen. Bless our fellowship downstairs around the table. Amen. Amen. We want to thank all those who participated tonight. We want to thank Jenny for coming again and doing a good job. You did a good job, Jenny. And the Cashmere Jack children, come twisted. And they did a great job. Our tree people here. And Robbie, thank you all. And thank you for coming. God bless you.